And, you know, all of the silly arguments, like Christmas is a pagan holiday, or, you know, December the 25th actually isn't Jesus' birthday, and all this nonsense. And the truth of the matter is, the Bible says the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. I promise you, the pagans don't own a single day that in God's calendar, do they? It's God's. And you know something? Anytime God has ever done something great or amazing, especially in Israel, didn't He appoint feasts to celebrate those same things? And there has never been in the world a more significant event to celebrate than the coming of our Savior Jesus. And Christian, just don't let anybody take that from you. Don't let them take it from you at all. You celebrate and you enjoy Christmas, not the commercialization aspect of it, but just enjoy God's love in this season. I hope you feel loved here today. Let me just welcome you. We have the Randolphs visiting with us. It's a pleasure to have you. They came as replacements for all of the people that went somewhere else for Christmas. And let me just say, we are delighted to have you guys today. Brother Randolph and his wife, they are servants of the Lord. He's just handed over the ministry after, was it 35 years that he pastored in the same place? Man, that is an amazing testimony, brother. 35 years pastoring in the same place in Arizona, and then he's from Michigan, so in my wife's mind, he's probably like, you know, basically a perfect person, I'm sure. And at least he married a perfect person, right? Anyway, we're glad that you're with us today. We're delighted that you've come. We do have a tear-off in our church bulletin for the, I call it a rip-off, but people don't like it put that way, but for our visitors to fill out. So if you've been given a church bulletin, you are visiting with us for the first time, will you please do us the honor of just filling that out so we'll have a record of your visit and slip that in the offering plate when it comes by, and that would be your part in this morning's offering. Then also, I wanted to remind the ladies about, is there ladies' prayer? There is ladies' prayer. This is on New Year's. Also, we're going to have, and we haven't had a chance to do this, it seems like in a little while, but we are going to have a game night after the evening service, and then we're going to have really a dedication time. I would love it if we could just give this year, 2018, give ourselves, give our time, our thoughts, our attention to the Lord. You know, it's been a good year. 2017 really has. You know, from May forward, my wife started just recording when people got saved through the ministries of Fort Lauderdale Baptist Church, and we're in the high 40s, I think, of people that have gotten saved since May, just through outreach and so forth, and a lot more probably than we know about. But the reality of it is that as good a year as this is, God can do a lot more. And we would just like to just next year really give ourselves, give our ministry to the Lord. And we'll be having a little bit of a dedication time during that game night on New Year's Eve. It'll be a good time for us individually and as a church to just say, Lord, here we are, and you can have us in 2018. You can do whatever you want so that we can see you do what you do when we're empty vessels. And so that'll be the next Sunday night following the evening service. Okay, you kids have been sitting a long time. Would you like to just stand up for just a second? Would you like to stand? Go ahead and stand up. Have the kids stand up. Okay. All right, now if you could just sit back down, please. Okay, if everybody could just shuffle a little bit this way. Just slide on your chairs just a little bit this way. A little more. You slide over a little bit. Okay. And then slide back this way. Okay. Seats needed cleaning. All right. That's it for announcements this morning. So I'm going to ask Charlie and Brother Andrew, why don't you stand in for Brother Lee? Why don't you come? And if you guys can take up this morning's offering. Charlie, would you pray and ask the Lord to bless it?
Let's pray. Father, thank you for this morning. Lord, I pray now that as we give, we'll be blessed to give the giver. Lord, thank you for everything that you've given unto us, Lord. And just that we even have just privilege and opportunity to be able to give just back unto you, Lord, a portion of what you've done for us in our life, even this week, Lord. So I pray now, Lord, that you would not only just bless, Lord, we'd be able to see much done with what comes in to be able to reach Fort Lauderdale and the world for you. And Lord, that you'd just speak to our hearts here this morning. Praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
She opened it. She opened it. And it fell on the floor. She opened it past the Christ and it opened it. Past the Christ and it opened
it. Ring the bells, ring the bells. Let the whole world know. Christ.
ring the bells, let the whole world know. Christ the Savior lives today, as he did so long ago. Ring the bells, ring the bells, what a glorious morn. Men and angels worship him, sing Christ is born. Born to die on Calvary, born to set his people free, God himself in human form, tell us Christ is born. He has left his royal throne, he has come to claim his own. For as the Lord has come to earth, go spread the news of Jesus' birth.